Aurora Usopp, and I am back. I am ready to rumble. Let us see what Bethesda hath wrought. Yes, I confess. I confess to a filthy sin. I confess to a sin of video game bigotry. You see, when I was a wee little Usopp, there was Wolfenstein. And then there was Doom. And then there was that one with the Cthulhu, and not Cthulhu, but Nyarlathotep, and I don't... Was that Unreal Tournament? No. Which one was the one that had a big Cthulhu monster? Literally a monster from Cthulhu as the main boss? But the thing is, these early first-person shooters had almost no plot, character, yada yada yada, Batman, Spam, Electronic Fish, Walrus. They were fun to run around and shoot things, but they turned me away from the first-person genre entirely. And so I never looked at things like Fallout or that game, that war game that ends with a nuclear bomb that was blew people away and actually had depth and stories. And the point is, I completely ignored the genre for way too long. And now I'm starting to open up and explore more wonderful things. As a consequence of which, I have almost no gaming reflexes for first-person shooters. I did get through Among the Sleep, which is not a shooter. I got through Amnesia, which is not a shooter. And I did get through Call of Cthulhu Dark Corners of the Earth, which technically has guns, but as a survival horror game, the shooting was not the major part of it. Is this song going to get me in trouble? Is this song going to get my video banned? Your admission that you I hope not. The and it better not. I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming I paid for this game. I should get to, you know, do things. Alright. I'm wondering if I should cut out the first few seconds. No, because that's where all my talk time was. Well, anyway, not all my talk time, but... Yeah, if I cut off everything before here, then I've lost a whole bunch of babbling. Anyway, there's a guy. I'm gonna call him Benji. Alright, so, other than watching a little bit on YouTube, I am more or less a Fallout virgin. So, well, this won't be completely blind.
War never changes.
Yes, it does. They started off with rocks, sticks, and spears.
Since the dawn of humankind. When our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice to simple psychotic rage.
Yes, yes, but the war itself has changed a lot. A whole lot.
In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation.
And somehow Bush wasn't responding. No, I'm not going to make a wisecrack like that. I apologize.
But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world.
Wow, that joke was
instead,
too late.
The apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history.
6 years.
For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes.
You can keep saying it, but it does change. The way we fight the war changes. The only thing that doesn't change is that war will always be there.
In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults.
Yes, and I already know about a couple of these vaults.
But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them.
Learning about the vaults was what got me into this
all except
curiosity
those
anyway,
vault
in the first place.
101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It
Ever?
Was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
You just said a whole bunch of people took refuge in there. If nobody ever entered, how was I born there? You, sir, are full of beans. Seriously. I don't know why I should take you seriously. Okay, there's a guy. Hello. Yes?
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
Who the hell are you, Professor Oak? Can you not tell? I mean, I know it's a baby, but look between the legs.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Is that...
Oh, James. We did it.
Talk again.
Son. My beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it.
That's Liam Neeson!
Look at you.
My dad is Liam Neeson!
Hi there.
Hi!
Daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Anna and I have been talking. What do you think about...
What do I think about? I think about a lot of things. I am going to call myself... My first thought is D'Artagnan, from the Three Musketeers, but I suddenly realize I can't spell D'Artagnan. And if I spell it wrong, I'm going to look like an idiot. So, I'm just going to call myself Smoochy Boots. No. Let's take this seriously. This is a serious game. Oh God, I can't resist. I promise I'm playing this seriously, but I'm still giving myself this name. Jack Splicer. Was it Spicer or Splicer? Nah, decided on another name. I don't know how to spell that either. You know what? Standard. Don't want to waste time.
Don't you think?
Damn right it is.
Perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Gene projection? All right. Caucasian, Hispanic, African-American, face, wait, it goes from 6 to 10, oh, there we go, no, I'm not going to be the love child, that one is a no, I'm not going to be the love child of Mo Howard and Mr. Spock, no, I don't want to be bald. That'll do. Alright, hairstyle. Shaggy suave. This could take a while. I'm just going to go ahead and pause the recording for a second. Alright, I briefly considered a disturbing porno stash, but mustache,
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
No, I'm not!
See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
Yes.
It's a big world out there, son. Full of all sorts of people.
Your eyes are creepy,
what
Dad.
You? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
Wait.
Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000.
Is his mother dying? 1,000. Am I in a Disney movie?
Hang on.
And why are you asking a newborn all of these questions?
We need a doctor, not a dead man. Fail to meet my expectations.
No, seriously, you can't expect a newborn to understand everything you just asked him. Seriously, if I had been a newborn, if he asked me to pick my name, my name would be Wang. Oh, great, now I'm in Among the Sleep again.
Just a little further.
Bite me. How do I pick things up?
Over here. You can do it.
All right, fine.
There
I'm here.
There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
A one-year-old should not be left unsupervised. Let's prove to him why that is. Whee! This is the best game ever. The playthrough will just be 20 videos of this. No, it won't. Alright, where's the gate? Didn't even lock it.
Mama.
You're special. I'm special. Yes, I am. S is for strength. That means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. Strength is good. P is for perception, a long, funny word. It means what I tasted, smell, saw, and heard. Nice. E is for endurance. That's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. C is for charisma. People think I'm great. Make my friends all laugh and smile and never want to hate. Possibly. Is intelligence one of these? I is for intelligent. Means I'm really smart. Use my brain for lots of stuff, like science, math, and art. I'm putting two in there. A is for agility. L is for luck. Alright, and then... Okay, I'll read the poems. A is for agility. That's how I get around. I move real fast and easy and never make a sound. That's where my last point is going. Alright. L is for luck. It's simple, you see. It means good things always happen to me. Alright, what if I hadn't, what if I hadn't looked at that book? Oh, it was probably a quest. Oh, yeah, it is a quest. Completed. Awesome. I'm ahead of the game. A Bible quote. Now I know this isn't a Nintendo game.
Quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Damn straight.
Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something.
You're not the boss of me.
It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega.
Yes, I just read it.
The beginning.
Oh, wait, I didn't read it out loud.
I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amato wants to play.
It's kind of a random passage. It doesn't seem particularly deep or meaningful or... I don't know. I mean, it does say God will, you know, provide for the thirsty, but...
These experiments
don't be a damn fool. The experiment...
Your mom's a waste of time.
Prepare.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
You let him into a transition scene.
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Yes, I am.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you.
I'm 10.
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I?
No.
Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibility.
Ow!
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it.
Yay, a giant clunky iPhone.
Work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
All right. Hi, Dad.
Having a good time? It wasn't easy keeping Mrs.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You're welcome.
But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff.
Well, it looks awesome.
Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
A pony! A pony! A pony! A pony!
Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian?
Conan!
That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Secret. Now go on. I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to the birthday boy.
Did Dad just pause talking and then resume where he left off?
Happy birthday, Sonny.
No problem. Bingo night. Awesome. Oh, I can't activate the... Damn straight.
Are you having a nice time?
Oh, I'm having a great time.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
It's because I'm awesome.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young
man. I need to read out what I say, I'm sorry.
I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Hey,
your mom.
Happy birthday, Nosebleed.
Who's being a dick to me on my birthday?
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came.
My daddy coming is none of your business.
Listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
I'm okay. I'm going to be a nice guy.
Sticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then.
I like you.
Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone.
Awesome.
It's time to cut the cake.
Okay.
Andy, wait.
Andy, you're kind of a dick. All right, I got a party hat. All right. Items. Apparel. Party hat. Awesome. Where's my sweet roll? Yum, yum, yum. Continue. I hit the wrong button.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake.
Yes, it
did.
Give
me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
Number one, I ate it. Number two, I'll shove it up your butt.
I would you look hungry.
What? Dang, I love those sweet rolls old Lady Palmer makes. Stay out of my way, you got it?
Who the hell are you? Your name is Butch.
But I'm not sure anyone else is.
Nonsense.
Your parents named you after... Oh, well.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium?
Yes, yes, Hunt the Commie Mutant Traitors.
You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Enjoy my
I am going to put a bullet in your head at some point. I predict it.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
Okay, so these guys are a little gang of jerk faces.
Listen, once you have finished being a good host, I have something I want to show
you. Introduce us to his best friend.
And it better involve you keeping your pants on.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
It's awesome.
As a matter of fact, I did.
I like
I'm glad
it.
You like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
I need to remember to read out what I'm saying. Okay, thanks, Stanley. What did you bring me? Yeah, thank you.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Here? Baseball cap. That is awesome. I'll put it on when I'm done wearing my party hat.
I'd like to wish you a happy birthday. I would offer you a piece of cake, but...
The thing is, the cake is still salvageable.
What'd Butch want? I thought you were in trouble there for a second.
The jerk tried to steal my sweet roll.
He really is a butthead. Oh well. You can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Thanks for coming, Stanley.
The thing is, the cake is still there. You can still eat it by the handful.
We need a good name.
Oh, sure. Nothing to worry about.
Seriously.
Again last night. Good as new.
Yeah,
I wasn't worried.
All right, I'm enjoying my birthday party.
Anyway, I'm glad you
made
it.
I'll send them right there.
Enjoying yourself?
Nice.
All right.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present.
I don't
Jonas
like surprises.
Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level.
I
Go
don't.
Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Number one, I don't like surprises. Number two, I don't like surprises in the reactor even less.
Hey, how about those bolt blowers?
Flashing arrows on my compass. I don't...
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
You look like a 50s housewife. I don't like any of these answers. Oh, there we go.
They sure did.
They threw me a great party.
My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you. A great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it.
Thank you, I'll treasure it always.
Course.
I'm going to be a nice
guy. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Oh, okay, she gave me a poem. I thought I was going to have to sit here and listen while she read me a poem. All right, now, I was told there were arrows on my compass, but I don't see any... Oh, okay. Lower left-hand corner, and when the arrow lines up with...
What are you doing down here, young man?